The 2022 Volkswagen Golf GTI takes a little bit getting used to compared to the old.
The old GTI is the one that so many people fell in love with.
Now let's start with the exterior. Now right off the back, I notice brake calipers are red, but they're not like Brembo or something like that. They're just, you know, painted red, probably to match the GTI badge. I do DIY videos and custom car videos as well, but I like to record new cars as well. You know, I don't like just old cars, I like new cars too. The body line sloping, the GTI, this one doesn't have a moonroof, but let's see if it's unlocked. Oh, that was abrupt. Springs open, so it's like spring loaded. Of course, the GTI got these plaid style seats, like we're Scottish still. Like, isn't this a German? It is a German car. Yeah, this is the GTI is the only one that does that. With, don't be fooled, there's a hint of Alcantara in here, right here. Don't be fooled. It looks like grown-up status in the front, so I'm just gonna hop in and see if I can. Yeah, it fits like a normal car. Two USB-C joints right here. Pretty standard on the interior. Couple of little pockets here. Oh, nice, pristine, nice crystal clear white lights here. The GTI is kind of it's kind of like regular car status. Like, that's why the name Volkswagen stands for, I think it's everybody's car or the person's car, the people's car. That's what it is. Volkswagen means the people's car. That's what Volkswagen stands for. But you can see from the back, the front seats have this nice little leather accents on there. I like that, that's pretty clean. And if you look throughout the interior, you can see a lot of little red accents right there on the steering wheel, on the shifting gear. Even the hazard light is red, accompanied with red stitching on the seats and on the armrest. And if you look closer, you can see red stitching on the shifter as well. This one is a stick shift. All right. That's actually pretty comfortable right here. This is comfortable. I don't know what it is about new cars. Maybe it's just new cars that are just comfortable to me. I don't know. But if you look right here, you can see more LEDs here. And it's accompanied with like a piano black, gloss black area right here. I'm not sure what this is or if it's just blank glass. These are obviously touch buttons. But look at this, it's like red going on. This is intense right here. Pretty reactive, you know, it works pretty quickly, you know. Let's go back to, a little confusing. ESC system, okay. Display unit, okay, you get the point. Clean start-stop button right there. And the way this stick shift, I'm sure it drives just like how my 5-speed drove that my old Volkswagen I used to have. Before I got my Audi years ago, I had a 5-cylinder Volkswagen Jetta. It was the bomb. I should have kept it and turbocharged it. Now the only car with the 5-cylinder is the RS3. But the seats in here are pretty decent, you know? These are comparable to like the Subaru WRX seats I was in recently. To be honest, I say the Subaru WRX seats are a little bit nicer, but you know, that was probably a higher trim. This one's comparable to the regular trim Subaru. It's got this cloth. The other one had more Alcantara. This one has a moderate amount of Alcantara, but you know, good thing you don't want a lot of Alcantara because this stuff wears horribly. But it is pretty. It's nice in a new car. It's nice to have that. You got a wireless charger right here. You got a little 12 volt thing right here. These are pretty standard. Basically, the whole inside of this car is pretty standard. It's not too crazy. You know, the seats are pretty nice though. Look at those. It's nice simplicity. Like, even if you look at the doors, it's just enough to get by, you know, without being bad. It's not super nice, but it's not ugly either. Look at this little window right here. My Audi does not have that. My other Volkswagen didn't have that. I haven't had a only other car in my life that has a small window in front right here. C10. Red badge, GTIs, signal lights. Here we go. Oh, that's cool. So to open the trunk, you have to do like this. And I see the interior is, you know, basic, pretty moderate size. You know, you got all your floor mats that it comes with, a little baggy, you know, instructions just in case you forget how to use your car. All this little extra stuff. Let's see if there's another additional storage.
Spare tire.
Of course, this is not automatic. This is not electric. This is not an Escalade. This is a GTI. But the GTI does have dual exhaust on the back of it. I know a lot of people like to see driving videos. You know, what's the purpose of driving if you don't even know you like the seats, you know?
Oh God.
Yep, this is not automatic. It's the heaviest hood I've lifted up in a while. Jeez, what is this, a Volkswagen? Okay, so this looks very similar to the engine I got on my car, except one thing that's weird is there's no engine cover. They changed the high pressure fuel pump. This intake tube is tiny. It looks super restrictive. Mine is like damn near double the size. Mine is like literally no joke like this big. You got your turbo. One thing I like about this is everything is so damn new. Everything looks pristine, crispy, clean. And you can see here, piano black right here. And your coolant reservoir. Yep, 2.0 turbo engine. Looks just like mine. PCV valve is exposed. Come on, where's the engine cover? I don't know why it's gone.